to be sure everything is okay, or is it possible to use adductor canal block plus IPAC block? The question is for you.
Yes, so you can put the first slide if you want. And you can see that I follow Olivier Rontes with the first lecture. And it was easy when we start together to perform blocks for knee surgery, major knee surgery.
That's true, that's true.
We want to have 70% of the analgesia, we perform femoral block.
Exactly.
And there is a posterior pain in the posterior part, and we perform a sciatic block. And thank you, I prefer like that. And we have 25% of the analgesia. And if the patient say, I'm not perfectly free, pain-free, we just add an obturator block. It was easy.
Exactly.
And these three main nerves, they give 10 branches. Here you see on the left part, 10 branches to the deep part of the knee. And there is a lot of variation. So you cannot, of course, the femoral nerve will give the innervation of the anteromedial part. The sciatic nerve branches will give the posterolateral part of the innervation. And if you perform distal block, you will target some of these nerves. And that's why when we perform distal block, if we perform adductor canal block and IPAC, so an infiltration between the popliteal artery and the femoral shaft, it is not possible to have 100% of analgesia after a total knee replacement. And how we do that, the adductor canal, one part of the slide is cut, but it is not so important. In real life, if I don't put a catheter, we don't see the lateral part of the slide, but that's not a big problem. I use the same needle. I will tell it to. I use a high frequency probe for the adductor canal, you will see. And I just want to target the femoral artery deep to the sartorius muscle, and I put my my probe at the middle third of the thigh. I will give to the patient only an analgesia to the anteromedial part of the knee, because the nerves that are target, if I have the R here, the saphenous nerve, the nerve to the vastus medialis, if I put my needle in the medial third, and the patellar branches in the femoral canal, in the middle of the thigh. And if I put a large volume of local anesthetic, I can have a spread along the femoral artery to the femoral triangle. And with a very high volume, I can have a femoral blockade, but I cannot predict. And if the local anesthetic is going down and I put my needle close to the adductor hiatus, I can have a spread to the popliteal fossa and a sciatic nerve block. And again, it is difficult to predict the spread. So since 1 year, I never put more than 15 milliliters of local anesthetic because I want to control the spread. What do we know? We know that if we perform an adductor canal, the quality of analgesia is a little bit inferior to the femoral nerve block, but the impairment of the quadriceps strength is less. For the pain, if you perform a good infiltration by a good surgeon, it's better than an adductor canal alone. But if you add an adductor canal to a periarticular infiltration, you improve the quality of the pain. And it's better to do the adductor canal proximally, not too distal. I think it's because you increase the quality of analgesia on the femoral vastus medialis nerve. The IPAC, I put my probe in the popliteal fossa, and I will target the connective tissue between the popliteal artery and the femoral shaft. And I will inject 20 milliliters of local anesthetic. But again, you cannot predict the spread. It is not a main trunk. It is small branches. So you can have in, I believe, I'm not sure of that, but in most situation, you have the superior branches, but you don't have the recurrent branches. So it is not a perfect block of the branches, the posterior branches to the posterior part of the knee. Sometimes you perform an IPAC, you have a beautiful spread on the screen, and the quality of analgesia is not good. I think I have no proof of that, but it is because you cannot predict the spread, and you don't, you are not sure that all the spread is going on all the branches. What I can tell you is that if you perform a femoral block without a sciatic nerve block, and you perform an IPAC, you improve the quality of analgesia. If you perform an IPAC and an adductor canal, the quality of analgesia is better than with an adductor canal alone. So if you decide not to perform femoral and obturator nerve block, if you combine IPAC and adductor canal, you have a pretty good quality of analgesia, but it is not as good as with the block of the main trunk, but you don't touch to you, the risk to impair the motor function is less. So, if it is my knee, Alain, my knee, for my total knee, I choose the technique of Olivier Rontes because I want to be pain-free during 24 hours. And the day after, that's life. If you promote the motor sparing analgesia, you have the choice between a good periarticular infiltration if you have a surgeon that takes the time to do it, and if not, the very good option is to perform you, the anesthetist, because you can control your spread under regional anesthesia. It is not. It is a good technique. It is my technique of choice for the ligamentoplasty, because we do that in outpatient, and we combine adductor canal, and I perform an injection along the tendon graft, and I combine in the IPAC, and the patient are really comfortable in the post-operative area. For a total knee, if the patient is not is a frail patient, I keep my femoral nerve block with my femoral canal with I go back. We go on the model?
Yes, I prepare.
So we have time to discuss.
Okay. So you can see that the debate is still open in between proximal blocks and distal blocks, in between femoral obturator and sciatic nerve blocks, in opposite on distal blocks with adductor canal blocks in IPAC. On the demonstration on adductor canal blocks and IPAC, I will ask to Olivier to show exactly the difference in between femoral triangle block, because you can observe that you have femoral block, femoral triangle block, adductor canal block, proximal injection, distal injection. We will ask him to show us this real difference. And the second time, for the IPAC, I will ask him to show us, do we have to inject proximally or distally to the femoral condyles, and where to inject, just close to the artery or closer to the bone, even if we inject just in between the artery and the bone. We will discuss about these topics just now with Olivier.
You can come, Alain, if you want.
You can go, Olivier.
Okay, so in real life, we have, this guy is young, he's thin, so it's not like that in everyday practice. So if it's single shot, if there is no catheter, I will take the same needle. And in many situations, I take a 10 centimeter long needle because I can perform the adductor canal and I can perform the two procedures. I have two syringes of local anesthetic. I take ropivacaine, 0.3 ropivacaine, and some we inject dexamethasone intravenously, or 1 milligram or 2 milligram in the syringe. You can you can make your choice. I will take I can in obese patient I only take the low frequency probe. I put a cover, of course, and I will just have a look. I don't take a lot of measure. I just want to put my probe in the middle of the thigh here, and I just want.
But what is the middle of the thigh for you?
The medial third of the thigh. I see the patella, if you want, the anterior and superior iliac spine, and you can cut in three parts, okay. And I will put my probe in the medial third. But after,
a lot of people say that the middle of the thigh is not the adductor canal block, but the triangle femoral.
It is a femoral canal. Adductor canal is okay, a wrong perfect. Denomination. Okay. I am at the level of the femoral canal. And I just want to see the sartorius muscle. And under the sartorius muscle, you have the femoral artery and the femoral vein. And I am happy. I just go down until I see that the artery is leaving the muscle. And when the artery is leaving the muscle, I am leaving the femoral canal. I am in the adductor canal. And if I go down, I go to the popliteal crease, I am no more in the adductor canal. So I will go up, just to show you that I will go, if I go up, I am in the femoral triangle. I don't want to perform the procedure in the femoral triangle.
Some people say that if you inject in the femoral triangle, you obtain the vastus medialis nerve in the same time than the saphenous nerve. If you go direct on the adductor canal block, you just will obtain only a saphenous nerve block. What do you think about?
If you go in the adductor canal,
yes,
you have the risk increased to have a spread to the popliteal fossa.
Absolutely.
And you have to follow the spread of your local anesthetic.
Okay.
When you have such it's always easy to follow the spread. I change my probe. I take this one. I go to nerve, I go to deep nerve, okay. So I can show you now the branches, okay.
Yes.
So the you have here, because it's a high frequency probe, and I will just take the mark, and you see I put just the mark, and I go up here. Okay, now you have the mark is on the one of the branches of the vastus medialis nerve. And if I go up, you see that the nerve is leaving the muscle and it goes close to the saphenous nerve now.
Yes.
You see?
Yes.
I go down and the saphenous nerve is now under the mark. Now you have the saphenous nerve under the mark and now you have the vastus nerve to the vastus medialis on the mark.
Yes,
and look at my hand. My hand is close to the femoral triangle.
Exactly.
So if I perform my adductor canal, a femoral
level,
canal block,
yeah.
I prefer this level.
Exactly.
And I will follow the spread.
Perfect.
If I see that the spread is going up, I stop. I have enough. Sometimes 10 milliliters is enough. And I go down and I follow the spread to the adductor canal. Now I go down.
When you can observe the two nerves or
yes,
branches, you inject on the two or only on the saphenous?
No. I just put
just
my
look,
there.
Look the spread, nothing there.
Now I
okay.
work out of plane in 90% of the cases, and my needle will go out of plane, deep to the skin, the fascia lata, the sartorius, and I just want to see the spread under the muscle that pushes away the at this place. I will inject at this plane. I just want to push the saphenous nerve away. That's
okay.
enough.
Okay.
And it is finished. It's very an easy block. It takes 1 minute. It's very easy
okay.
to perform.
I will show most you of the people want to know at what level exactly you will inject.
It doesn't matter. You follow the spread. I think you
okay.
have to follow the spread.
Perfect.
I will try to show you the saphenous nerve is leaving the... Okay, you have... I will just want to see. Okay, here I am at the level of the genicular artery. So the artery is leaving the adductor canal and the saphenous nerve here stay. I just put the mark. The saphenous nerve is superficial and you have the artery is leaving The anterior part and is going to the popliteal area. So I wanted to show you that if you perform a distal block in the adductor canal in itself, you can have a spread to the popliteal fossa. So I have performed how many minutes? I have 5 minutes?
Yeah, yeah, perfect.
Five minutes.
So you're quite.
So in real life, again, if I have an obese patient, I will just take. Okay, sorry. I go to nerve, and I go to. I will change if needed. The preset, 10 centimeter. It's okay. I can go to 8 because he is a thin patient. But if the patient is obese, I can take. I can go to 8 centimeters, to 10 centimeters if the patient is obese, and 8 if it is a thin patient. He is thin, so I Perfect. Can take between 7 and 8, it's okay. So again, I am at the level of the adductor. I go there, up, I am in the adductor canal. I go back to the femoral canal. I will perform my procedure at this level, and I will follow the spread. I don't turn my patient. Because there is a risk of wrong side. If I turn my patient, that's I good. Forgot to go on the other that's leg, that's and good. I can make an error. You so I stay like that. I just ask the patient, if he is not painful, I put the leg on my
even if
belly.
For, even
you know?
If for a beginner, it's probably easier.
Difficult. But this
no,
technique...
No, no. Yes. To move the patient
yes, because
in the prone position.
To do that, what I will show you now, it's very difficult.
Yeah.
This way, but I do it like Sina describes the technique. It is Sina who describes the technique. Yes. And I put my probe. For the beginner, I say, put your probe. I will just take the gel if you want to see something. Okay. I will. Okay. Now I am happy. And you see, I will take the mark.
You so now you don't see the condyles, eh? You see the shaft at
the
this level.
Now I go in the popliteal crease and I have the condyle.
Exactly.
If I have the condyle, it is too caudal. Exactly. I have to go until I am at the level of the shaft again. Perfect. I am at the level of the shaft, and now I am just above the condyle.
And when you will inject closer to the bone, or closer to the artery, just in between?
Close what? To the artery.
Close
and you know
to
why?
The artery.
And you
no,
know why?
I ask a question.
Because the genicular nerve, they follow the artery, the branches. And the autonomic nerve Perfect. Are along the artery.
Also, yes.
So, and if you hit the capsule, when the surgeon opens the knee, he sees the local anesthetic.
Exactly.
And he says, oh, what are you doing? Uh-oh, Alain Delbos, what are you doing? So, again, the anatomy, the femoral shaft, the artery. I relax my probe, the pressure, and you have the artery and the vein. And here you see the sciatic nerve.
Yeah.
So I will come from medial, if you see my finger, from medial, when I start... The first procedure, I was putting my needle close to the probe, but it's not a good idea because you have the tendon and it is painful for the patient. So now I am perpendicular to the probe and I am parallel to the surface of the probe. If you
don't
want.
Take any risk with the saphenous nerve?
No, the saphenous nerve is just more superficial.
Okay, perfect.
Okay. And you push the nerve with a short bevel needle. You don't cut the nerve with a short bevel needle. So
exactly.
if you touch the saphenous nerve, you can see it in some patients. The saphenous nerve is, I don't try to see it with this probe, but it is very superficial. And I go horizontally under the artery. I will show you, the needle will do that. So it is not for beginners. And I will put the tip of my needle under the artery. I am happy.
Show me the entrance point
here.
Just here.
Yeah, you see the tissue
exactly.
are moving.
You can observe it's already 3-4 centimeters deep.
Quite horizontally.
And quite horizontal
so
to the probe.
It is difficult if you are not trained, it is difficult to see the needle at the beginning.
Exactly.
But you see the movement of the tissue, and I stop my needle under the artery. I don't go in the lateral part. Because on the lateral part, there is the sciatic nerve, which is there. And if I see the spread going to the sciatic nerve, I withdraw my needle of one centimeter.
You inject lateral, medial, and
No. Posterior.
Posterior and medial only.
Posterior and medial.
Okay.
Not lateral. If I have lateral, I have no proof, but I increase the risk of anesthesia of the common peroneal nerve.
Yeah.
And the lateral part is anesthetized, and there is a foot drop. And after a total knee replacement, I don't want to have a foot drop. If I want this, I want that the patient walk late in the afternoon, not early in the afternoon, but in the late afternoon. So I put 20 milliliters of local anesthetic. I move a little bit, sorry, under the artery, and after I withdraw the needle and I inject local anesthetic in the connective tissue here.
Perfect.
And at this place, I know that I can have the recurrent branches from the saphenous nerve. So when I have done that, with the adductor canal, I have an analgesia of the medial part and anterior or medial part of the knee. With the IPAC, I have a partial, not a complete analgesia of the posterior part. So my analgesia is good, but it's not perfect.
Yeah, but you can walk immediately.
Yes. You decrease the risk of foot drop, of muscular impairment of the quadriceps, and the patient can walk if it's not too painful, but in many patients, after a total knee, we need to give opioids.
Exactly. The problem in this case is we need a lot of opioids sometimes.
Yes, and we put a catheter in the adductor canal.